cashier walked out of the Monarch Casino with $500,000 in cash.
500,000.
I'm down in my office right now, doing some work, getting ready for the next vlog, when I run across this story, and you are not going to believe it. I gotta share it with you. Let's head over to the desk. I'm gonna get set up. I'm gonna read this story to you. Ocean's 11 is one of my favorite movies of all time. If you think Ocean's 11 is cool, wait till you hear this. All right, Black Hawk, Colorado, the largest casino heist in Colorado history happened as the clock sprung forward earlier this month. Investigators said early in the morning, daylight savings time began, a cashier walked out of the Monarch Casino with $500,000 in cash. No, that's not the same as Ocean's 11, but that's a huge amount of money that an employee just took and got out of the casino. But here's how they did it. There's video captured where the employee is reaching into the vault of the casino's cage and just grabbing stacks of $50,000 each. They didn't take down the security system. They didn't roll in on wires. They didn't blow the vault doors. Just sitting there grabbing them with her hands, just her mitts, just $50,000 at a time. Each time Eddie grabbed the stacks, she placed the stacks into the same box. She's just got a box. There's no like, you might as well just go in with a shopping bag to Safeway and just start pulling stuff off the shelves. It's the same move, right? It's the same move. She's just looting a casino as an employee. The affidavit said Eddie walked out of the casino cage into the parking garage and got into a gold minivan. Now that's a sweet escape vehicle. And she drove off. She returns an hour later. So it gets more bizarre than we thought. She returns an hour later, investigators said, and grabbed four more bricks of bills. So now she's got another 200,000. The total is $500,000 in all. They go on to talk about how big this is. They won't comment on it. But now you got to hear what she says. So she gets to tell her side of the story. She told investigators she received a call on the casino's phone from a man purporting to be Monarch's head of operations. He and another man, who she believed was a cage manager, while exchanging texts with him, told her the casino was having a problem with a UPS order and needed the money or the casino would be in breach of contract. She just gets a call, hears that it's her boss because they tell her it's her boss, and now she's just going to go take money out of the vault, throw it in a box, and go drive it somewhere else. She said the two men told her the funds would be delivered to a lawyer. She brings the box to St. Anthony's Hospital. Why that made sense, I don't know, where a man came to her door and took it at approximately 4:36 in the morning. She tries calling back. They don't answer. And then she calls the casino to inform them that she's returning. And the casino is saying, what? What did you do? So she says, hey, I think I might be arrested. Maybe this wasn't what I thought it was. She'd been instructed by the casino member. But here's the thing I want you to take away from it. In Ocean's 11, they spend all of this time. They go through blueprints. They put the plan together. They've got a team of 11 guys. Each one's going to do the perfect job at the perfect time. And if they get everything just right, they're going to make millions of dollars. This dude just gets a ski mask and a burner phone. Doesn't even get a ski mask. You don't even need a ski mask. He just gets a burner phone, makes a phone call to the casino, gets in touch with this employee and says, hey, bring me a giant box of money and I'm just going to meet you at the hospital where you can hand it to my associate. All right, here's the original five steps you needed in order to rob a casino. Step number one, assemble a crew. Step number two, get a wealthy investor to back your operation. Step number three, surveil your target and learn everything you can about their operation. Step number four, train and practice your roles in order to prevent missteps. Step number five, flawlessly combine all of your training and information to pull off an elaborate heist without being caught. Here are today's five steps that you need in order to pull off a robbery of a casino. Step number one, find the phone number of the casino. Step number two, buy a burner phone. Step number three, call an employee and ask them to put money into a box. Step number four, acquire a suit and choose an unusual drop-off location. And step number five, have the employee drive their gold minivan to meet you at that strange drop-off location. Don't be a scumbag. Don't do that. But my goodness, what a story. Had to share it with you guys. Hope you're doing well. Thanks for watching. Catch you next time.